sake, thanks so much for making time for me to speak. You're not in Toronto right now. Are you in BC? Where are you right now?
We are in Lakefield, Ontario.
Okay, so you're close by because, of course, as we're speaking, we're a couple of days away from Chevrolet Indy Fridays. Your band is going to be performing with us here in Toronto. I got to ask, how does it feel being part of something that has really become something iconic, something very important, something fans love with this summer music concert series, which is free?
It feels amazing. We're very, very excited to be a part of it. We've definitely been to lots of concerts at Yonge and Dundas Square over the years, and one of our band members is from Toronto, so he especially has grown up going to concerts there. So it kind of feels surreal that we finally get to perform there.
So wait a minute, because you guys are traveling and he lives in Toronto, does that mean you guys are going to stay over there so you don't have to do a hotel thing?
He's from Richmond Hill, so we'll stay with his family in Richmond Hill, and then we don't have to do the hotel thing.
Fantastic. Look, I gotta say, I love the music, and it's so, like, it's kind of funny, because I was thinking to myself, if you guys are back in the 90s or whatever else, I think you guys have probably been called, maybe it's alternative, I'm not even sure. Now it's like this alternative folk electronica rock, like, it's really hard to describe you guys.
Yeah, it's really, we definitely pull from a range of influences, and I think it's likely because all of us in the band write, so we're definitely pulling in different inspirations, and so it just kind of becomes a mashup of different influences that somehow all kind of work together.
Definitely does. How did you guys get together? And I mentioned DC, and again, correct me if I'm wrong, that's where you guys are from?
We live in Fernie, British Columbia.
How did the band get together?
Our banjo player, Tim, he was hosting an open mic night at one of our local bars there called the Brick House, and we were all just going there with different groups and different people kind of playing at the open mic, and then he had written a few songs and needed to get a band together, so he just kind of pulled people from the open mic night who were there playing various instruments and put together a band, and then we've been together ever since. So we're approaching our 9-year anniversary.
Wow. Congratulations with that.
Thank you. Love that.
And you guys are award winners too, because you guys have gotten a lot of awards on the west side of Canada.
Yeah, there's been some recognition with some nominations and wins with the West Coast Music Awards, and then also with the Kootenai Music Awards as well. So yes, it's definitely nice to receive the recognition and be among so many other great artists in the categories that we've been nominated in.
Now, you kind of mentioned, the style of music, but lyrically, what do you guys like to talk about? Because especially when I talk about with this latest single, not just the album, but the single and the video, because I had a chance to watch that too, which I think is very, very cool.
Oh, thank you. Lyrically, it's definitely lots of different inspirations. So we're definitely have been inspired sort of by the Canadian landscape and where we're from and where we live now and our roots in Ontario, as well as things like relationships and kind of the relationships that we have in the modern age. So the lyrically, we write kind of all about different things. I guess it all depends on when we're writing that album and kind of where we're at individually or as a group and kind of what the inspirations are, but kind of no topic is off topic, so it's just kind of whatever is inspiring us at the moment.
Now, is it me, because I've heard a couple of songs and I find that you guys, which I think is cool, a lot of bands like to, you'll hear like a little bit of interlude in the beginning, a couple of beats or whatever, and then the lyrics come in. I find that with your music, there's a long interlude. There's a lot of music going on before you guys start singing. Am I off that, or yes or no?
Yeah, that could be right. We initially, because of how we started, we played a lot of shows. Initially, we were just playing a lot of shows live, and so before we even kind of thought we'd be a recording band, we were just kind of doing the live thing. And so when we first started, all of our songs were really, really long, because live, it doesn't really, there's no kind of cut mm-hmm. off to how long a song needs to be. And so over the years, the songs have kind of got a little bit shorter and shorter, but we definitely have a hard time writing songs that are kind of in that 3.5 minute range, because we're always like, oh, let's keep adding this part or extend the intro or add a breakdown, because it's more fun when we're saying why to add those things. But sometimes we're trying to condense that a little bit for the recorded version, because you're not kind of getting the live energy on the record, so you're not there, so it's sometimes nicer to condense it a little bit.
I like the long versions. I say stick with the long versions. I love that. I can't even pronounce it. The name of the new album is, again, what is it?
Archipelago.
What does that mean?
So that's a group of islands that are close together. And so that song was sort of written about, we had a week off after our first tour in Europe. We went to Sweden to visit a friend, and she took us to her cottage just on, in an area called the archipelago. And it was just an area right on the ocean, and there were lots of little islands around it. And when we got there, it was pretty much, it looked exactly like Ontario, and there was a moose swimming across the lake, and there were northern lights, and we were like, oh, it's not all that different here in the archipelago. And that's sort of where that song inspiration came from.
Wow. The latest single?
Yeah, that was our first single, Archipelago. So we put that one out first in August, and then Don't Ever Look Back in February.
Okay, Don't Ever Look Back, the video on that. I don't want to give too much away, but can you describe it? Because this is very, very cool. I actually thought to myself, if Alanis Morissette saw that, she would have been kicking herself going, damn, why didn't I write that and do that video?
Yeah, that was a really amazing collaboration, because we worked with a film company called The Light Factory in Calgary, and they had one of the video directors, he had been to a play in Calgary called Heterophobia, and it was kind of about if social norms were flipped, and if being gay was the norm and being straight was not. And so it kind of just explores someone kind of navigating their feelings for someone of the opposite sex, which is sort of not accepted by her family and peers, and sort of that internal struggle. And so it really went well with the lyrics, and even the playwright, Pam Rocker, her and her partner make a cameo in the video, and she helped write the script as well for the video. So it became this really amazing collaboration, and it gave a lot more depth to the song, just having the video. It really brought it to life even more for me.
I, you know what, I'm hoping that you guys are submitting that video to whatever award shows that are out there, because honestly, I think it's one of the best videos I've seen in a long time. It's like a mini movie for, you know, the 3-4 minutes. Absolutely amazing.
Oh, thank you so much.
What's the show going to be
like? Amazing job.
Absolutely. What's the show going to be like when you get down here for Young Dundas Square? What can you expect from your set?
Oh, it's going to be, all of our shows are very high energy, so lots of dancing, hopefully, and we definitely move around a lot on stage, so hopefully the audience is dancing and getting into it as well.
It's going to be a big crowd. So far, we've had some really good crowds, so I'm looking forward to that, because, of course, I get to introduce you guys, so I'm looking forward to that. Social media-wise, where do we go to follow you?
We are on Instagram at ShredKelly, and Twitter and Facebook as well.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. Say hello to the band for me. Looking forward to meeting you guys. But more importantly, I'm just looking for you guys to tear up down at the Young Dundas Square. Thank you again for the interview.
Yeah, thanks so much. See you on Friday.
You got it. Take care. Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye.